Hey YouTube, what is up? This video I am introducing the Trexo wheels and then review it. This is the unboxing portion of the video. Skip using the bookmarks below if you're not interested. It looks like we have a discount code. Here's the discount code. I'm sharing it. The wheels come packed in a card cover case. On first time opening, everything is wrapped in plastic wrap. This is the turntable cover. Next we have the Trexo Wheels launch pad. It feels a lot like a mouse pad. This is the turntable itself. At first it is connected with the Trexo wheels, so you will have to take it off. I didn't know you can just pop off the turntable, so I was twisting it off. So here is the Trexo itself. And then we got the camera mount. This is the cell phone mount. It's spring loaded. Be careful. And a USB-A to USB-C cable for recharging. Okay, let's go over the parts individually. The charging port and the camera trigger for the panoramas is on the left side of the camera. When plugged in, the recharge icon blinks until it is full. A full charge can hold a 2-hour battery life. You turn on the Trexo by swinging open the third wheel. The wheels come equipped with ultra-silent wheels. Let's listen one more time. The camera mount is built pretty solid, like solid steel it may be, with a quick release swivel point for the camera. With two threads to mount it vertically or horizontally. The engineers at Trexo did a good job on having the screw underneath the Trexo wheels for easy mounting. To perform the manual controls on the wheels, you first double tap the triangle and learning will appear. You then teach where you want the Trexo to go by pushing it along the table. Double tap the triangle to watch it return back to origin. Then you press and hold the triangle to let it play what it has just learned. For creating curves, it's the same step as the linear learning, but with the circle button instead. Making a curve can be a little awkward, so it will take a couple tries to get a hang of it. It is actually quite accurate. I'll nitpick a little bit about it later. The app is downloadable on Android and iPhones. Let's go over the app starting with the circular path. If you set the radius to 0, send the command to the Trexo and press play, the Trexo will spin in circles for panoramic shots or turntable shots. It is important to note that the center of the rotation is the screen on the Trexo wheels. Let's move on to the linear path module. You can set the distance and duration of the travel. Set the ease in, ease out setting. Once you're happy, send to device and play. The orbital path is much trickier and helps if you have a ruler to measure the radius. You can set the degree you want to have the trexo to travel, which is pretty neat and very fun to play with. Setting up the turntable is pretty easy. You first flip it over, then take out the bottom mounting screw. Flip it back over. Add the tripod mounting screw. Attach it to the tripod. The trexo will be upside down, so try not to accidentally press the buttons on the trexo. Then finally, you attach the turntable. What is nice is the turntable cover is non-slip. I noticed that there's no manual way to use the turntable, and you will have to use the app to operate the turntable in circular mode. Circular path mode, I mean. Final thing to show off in the app is the camera pathing. You will need the launch pad and your camera. Take a photo of your table in a bird's eye view. And then you can draw the path by double tapping on the photo. You can draw turns for the trexo, but I'm going to just make it go in a straight line. For testing purposes, I wanted to see where the end of the orange line corresponds to the trexo. It appears it lines up with the back edge of the trexo. So if you line up the orange line with the front of the trexo will not run off the table. Here's an example of using the camera path to create a scene. The wheel costs $700 on their webpage. I really like it, but I have some things I have to nitpick with it. My first criticism is, every time you use the camera path and take a photo, it sometimes warps and you will have to retake the photo. Each new photo will be saved to your phone and your phone will be filled with photos. The next issue I found, which is very minor and it doesn't make or break the machine, the trexo often overshoots its learned movement path. Here's an example. I moved the trexo all the way to the edge of the table and 8 out of 10 times the trexo will fall off the table. It's not really a complaint but more of a warning because you don't want to break your trexo once you first get it. My next comment is a suggestion. Why didn't Trexo use a QR code on top of the Trexo itself instead of making a launch pad? Having the app recognize the Trexo itself would eliminate the need for the pad. Also, although it is a novel idea, the camera pathing is hard to use since people need to see what the camera on the dolly sees for the scene. I'm willing to bet 9 out of 10 times people will opt for the manual mode over the camera pathing mode. My only issue with the turntable is that there is no method to manually turn on the turntable mode. You will have to use the app in order to use the turntable. Another comical issue I have is, let's say you sent a path to the trexo already, and then you accidentally press the play button when you want to use it manually. There is no manual way to stop the trexo besides using the app or turning the trexo off manually. Overall, it's a great product, and I really like the versatility of it. For the price, it has great features, but the cost may not justify its practicality. Personally, I am going to keep it despite knowing I will seldomly use the camera pathing, and is what it's known for actually. I will mainly use the manual controls and the turntable. Thank you for watching this video, and enjoy the rest of your day. Please leave a comment if you went out to buy a trexo, and let me know what you think about it.